Yo, what's going on, guys? Chris Bonner here, Overtime Athletes. So for today's video, what I wanted to discuss is the full laid out plan for off-season basketball performance. Now, I just released my newest program, Built to Ball, that basically outlines all of this. So if you guys are interested, go ahead and check out the full 14-week program down below. But just like anything, anytime I release a new program or I design it, I wanna obviously work it out with my athletes here, get results, drive results, and then be able to share it with you guys. And obviously this outlet of YouTube, I'm able to kind of share the bone, the frameworks of what that off season looks like that has got some amazing results. So just to kind of paint the broad stroke, I'll probably go in deeper into some of these concepts in later videos. But you guys have seen some of the videos as far as the actual training. So here it is laid out in layman's terms. So first and foremost, you're looking at a four-phase program that follows a more block periodization style of training. Remember, I only get guys for a particular amount of time, anywhere from a little over 3 months usually for the basketball off season. Those four phases within block periodization, you have your standard accumulation, transmutation, realization, but in before that, usually what I do is a period of two, anywhere up to 4 weeks of, you know, what we call GPP, general prep phase, where we're just, you know, a lot of it is accumulating that volume, getting that work capacity up, really standard vanilla movements. For this particular program, we did about 2 weeks until we got straight into our accumulation phase, which is kind of an extended version of the GPP. It's just a little bit more advanced. If you wanna break these terms down, if you're not familiar with block periodization, you can think of it as foundation, right? You know, integration, where we go a little bit more intermediate movements, advance those movements, and then translation, where our last thing, where we get a little bit more specific, sport specific, and really try to transfer everything that we've been building in the weight room over to the court. So that's how you want to think of that progression throughout. Each one is meant to build on each other. So if you think of block training, think each block builds its way up, just like you're climbing some stairs. Now, within each of these phases, you have four sessions per week. With these four sessions, I predominantly go back and forth between upper and lower. So you have 2 days upper body focus and 2 days lower body focus as far as your strength and auxiliary work. In between those 2 days, you're gonna have 2 days that focus on triphasic. You guys know and familiar with that. I'm a big proponent of triphasic modalities, essentially brought forth by Cal Dietz. Make sure that you check out his book, Triphasic Training. This is where we're really building that, not only that power, I won't go deep into the eccentric, isometric, concentric. I have other videos for that, and you can obviously, again, check out his book. But this is where we really build that relative strength with the athlete and develop that power, moving that weight fast. Well, for the concentric, actually, I should say. But then the other 2 days are gonna be focused around absolute strength, where this is the total amount of resistance we can overcome. So whereas, you know, day one of lower body might be an accommodating resistance back squat with a 5 second eccentric tempo, your second time that you hit a lower body is gonna be like a trap bar deadlift, where we focus on, you know, 5 sets of 3 repetitions, overcome the maximum amount of resistance we can overcome, right? So we're really building that balance between triphasic and absolute strength and going back and forth between those two. Beyond that, beyond our strength, going back to our speed, power, agility, quickness, things of that nature, each phase is broken down into one unilateral plyometric focus day. So especially with basketball players, I focus on building from the ground up, you know, from lower level to deceleration, transition to acceleration, all through the plyometric spectrum, right? So what that looks like is, for unilateral, we focus on lower level, a lot of pogos, a lot of lower limb stuff. Then we'll focus on landing, then we'll focus on that transition, then we'll focus on force production, right? So we do that with both unilateral, single leg, and bilateral, which is double leg. So not only are you getting the benefits of being able to jump off 1 foot if you want to increase your vertical. We're doing the same thing to balance out off of 2 feet as well. Not only that, most basketball players tend to focus strictly on vertical work. And yes, it does transfer to other movements, but I like to focus on horizontal power as well as lateral power as well. So you get really balanced and the athlete isn't lacking when they go to actually perform on the court. There's a difference between these guys who dunk in the dunk contest who typically ride the bench as opposed to guys who are well balanced and you know, typically see the court. Another day that we focus on with that is our power. So I actually like to work down that force velocity curve and introduce med balls in a power setting. So we do a balance of different types of throws where we get the entire body involved, whether it be a vertical toss with the med ball, a broad toss. We could do overhead throws, chest passes, rotational passes, just a real balanced approach to our med ball power training. But in any event, we're doing ballistic style movements where we're moving a load extremely fast velocities, okay? So that's where our power day comes in, and that's balanced out usually with an upper body day. And then finally, your fourth day of it, right? So we have unilateral one day, bilateral second day, power one day, and then speed, agility, and quickness. Now this is a little bit more specific to the basketball athlete's needs. You don't need to be performing, you know, 20, 30 yards of linear speed. That's not gonna necessarily, it translates somewhat, but it's not as specific to what the needs analysis of an actual basketball player is. Really what I focus on is quick A cell and D cell in multi-directions, right? Instead of focusing on those long linear runs or, you know, conditioning in that fashion, we're trying to build up quick change of direction, that quick first step burst, so that their footwork is, you know, whether they're changing, you know, linear to lateral or lateral to linear, we're developing that quick twitchiness to be able to move fast in multiple directions. So your speed, you will have some linear, but you know, with basketball, you're performing a lot of arc runnings or quarter arc or full arcs, figure eights where you're getting around picks, things of that nature that are gonna translate over to the basketball court. So there you have it, guys. I just wanted to break down exactly what the program looks like so that if you can't invest in the program, you can at least structure your workout to get maximal results. If you want the full program, including body weight and a beginner guide, go ahead and check out the link down below. You guys can get it. But there you have it. I hope this helps you guys out. Full basketball offseason handed to you. I'll get a little bit deeper as we go through the next series of videos. I'll catch you guys next time.